Hey everyone, my name is Alfred Sin, and I'm a program manager working on Azure Automanage. Thanks for joining this session. Today I'll be talking to you about managing your servers with both Azure Automanage and Azure Arc. So Azure Automanage is a fairly new service. We're actually still in public preview as of today. So I'll give you an overview of how we got to Azure Automanage, the customer problems we're trying to address, and we'll talk about how we intersect with Azure Arc. I think once you understand the story, it'll actually make a lot of sense that we're bringing Automanage over to Arc. So that being said, let's talk about how we got here. So one customer challenge, kind of overarching customer challenge that we're aware about is the complexity of IT management. Sysadmins have to stay up to date with so many different things and deal with so many different challenges on a day-to-day basis. We spoke to a lot of these customers and, you know, we kind of ended at three different buckets of kind of where the challenges lie. One is just the OpEx overhead. So the continuous day-to-day nonstop tasks of just making sure things are backed up properly, making sure you're ready for any sort of disaster recovery scenarios, making sure you're staying on top of updates, making sure you're staying on top of security and whatnot. That kind of takes us to my second point, which is the whole improving operational security. So sure, you can classify operational security under OpEx, but it's also worth its own separate call out because of the sheer work that's required in staying up to date against the latest threats. So that's extra time, extra OpEx that our sysadmin customers have to take into consideration when they're managing their IT workloads. And then the third piece, the third challenge that customers shared with us was keeping pace with cloud innovation. So, you know, the whole prospect of Azure building out new features and delivering new things so quickly makes it a challenge for customers to stay on top of what's new, what's happening, which API surface is going to be helpful, which API surface might be deprecated in the future, which one they should move to, just staying up to date with all these management tools that are being built so regularly. Now, some of the customer commentary we received that kind of backs up our thoughts are, you know, we received these two pieces. You know, customers don't want to manage their servers or spend time on menial tasks. And then another kind of Fortune 500 apparel and sporting goods company basically told us that anything that differentiates, well, anything that simplifies the day-to-day management of the OS is a differentiator. So these are things that we kind of kept in the back of our minds as we were coming up with the idea and the scope of Azure Automanage. Now, here's kind of a summary of another summary of some of the feedback that we received. Customers don't really have any motivation to refactor their line of business workloads to cloud native. So in other words, if customers are running something on some servers on-prem, then if it's working, then why would they want to refactor that and go through all the effort of making sure it works again in another environment? Which kind of takes me to my second point, which is that the cloud represents not much more than a different place to incur the same level of OpEx. It's just a different environment. Here's an example. If you're doing backup on-prem, well, you probably want to do backup in the cloud. And if you're doing monitoring on-prem, well, you probably want to set up some sort of monitoring in the cloud and so on and so forth. You can think about it similarly with updates. So that's another challenge that customers have. And then the third piece, which, you know, we've touched upon a moment ago, it's just hard to maintain lockstep with the cloud's pace of change. There's so many things happening in the cloud all the time. It's hard to stay on top of those. So some lessons that we learned from all of this feedback, customers still have these line of business applications running on what we call classical computing architecture. So there's millions of bare metal or virtualized server OS instances that are still running around on premise. And these line of business applications really aren't going anywhere. So there's this huge long tail of them that just work. So what's the point of doing anything to them if they will just work and serve their needs? So we have to ask ourselves, we as Azure and, you know, the Automanage team, can we simplify and add value to these classical computing scenarios? Which takes us to the next point about what might be missing here. I'm sure we're all familiar with the paradigms of IaaS and PaaS and SaaS, you know, IaaS being just a standard lift and shift, migrate your workloads from a server on-prem to a VM in the cloud, PaaS being, you know, any sort of platform service that's offered, SaaS and kind of the panacea of PaaS and SaaS. But there, we figure there's something missing in the middle that helps kind of bridge the gap between infrastructure and platform/software as a service, something that makes that transition a little bit easier. And we were kind of calling it OS as a service, where, you know, you kind of take care of the day-to-day repetitive management operational tasks at the operating system level for the customer. So we replace those repetitive day-to-day tasks with this exception-only management model, where if things are working, you don't hear from us. Only if things have failed, if something has really, really, truly gone wrong with your VM, that's when you'll hear from us. So that's where we landed with Azure Automanage. Currently, we have an offering called Azure Automanage VM Best Practices. This is based on a set of best practices that's published in the Cloud Adoption Framework, which is a publicly available document. If you just search for Azure Cloud Adoption Framework, that'll get to it. Basically, what we do is we will eliminate the need to discover and onboard to select best practice Azure services. So for example, if you're onboarding a bunch of VMs to the cloud and you're not sure which services to use them to use with your VMs for kind of your optimal Azure experience, we take care of that headache for you. So we have a curated set of best practice services. You don't have to figure out what they are. You don't have to figure out how to onboard them. We'll do that for you. We'll configure them for you per Azure best practices. We'll also apply a guest OS baseline. So there's a Windows baseline and there's a Linux baseline that we apply to your VMs, and that will just configure your VMs per a bunch of security recommendations. We will also monitor your virtual machines for drift. And what we mean by drift is, let's suppose backup gets disabled on your virtual machine after you've onboarded to Automanage. Well, if backup gets disabled, then all of a sudden you might not have any more backups left to fall back on in the event of any sort of interruption to your business, to your application or your workload. So in that case, we as Automanage would actually monitor for backup. And if something gets misconfigured, we'll detect that as drift, and we'll correct for that across the VM's entire lifecycle. Backup is just one example. There's a few more. I'll talk about them in a moment. And from an onboarding perspective, we offer a point-and-click portal experience. So again, I'll demo that to you in a moment as well. We also offer an Azure policy for at-scale scenarios. So if you want to onboard a large amount of VMs onto Azure Automanage, and we also offer ARM templates. So you can enable Automanage via ARM. Now you're probably wondering where this all fits with Arc. So the exciting thing is that we're actually making Automanage available over Arc. So the following services, so these six services on the left side of the screen that you see, are the services that are available to Arc-enabled Automanage servers. So OS baselines, as I mentioned, will enable Azure Guest Config and will apply a certain baseline to your machines. With VM updates, we'll onboard you to Azure Update Management, which allows you to then create your own schedules and define when machines get patched and when they get rebooted for patches. Monitoring will enable monitoring services, so VM Insights monitoring and log analytics on your machines. We'll also enable Azure Change Tracking and Inventory, which lets you have a look at when, you know, files or programs might have been changed inside your machine. We'll also onboard you to Azure Security Center. And then, of course, a supporting service is the automation accounts. So this is required by a couple of the underlying services here. Now, two other noteworthy services that I'll call out. These are currently only available in Azure Automanage, not available in Automanage over Arc. But if you onboard a virtual machine to Automanage, you'll also get backup and anti-malware in the form of the Microsoft IIS anti-malware extension. So this has been a lot of words. I've said a lot of things. So let's hop into a demo in the portal. Then I'll show you what I really mean by Automanage and Arc. So let's pop into here. Here I've got my Azure portal. This is the Automanage blade in the Azure portal. So you can find this by simply searching for Automanage. In my case, I'm already here. So to onboard a VM, so let's do this. We'll onboard a machine onto Automanage. It'll be an Arc server, and we'll maybe throw in an extra VM as well, just for fun. So this is the enablement flow. So there's three pieces to this. There's the machines, there's the configuration, and then optionally there's an advanced section. So for machines, this is where the Arc piece comes along. So we go into here, and then we can just search for a bunch of machines. All of mine show up, and then I will just onboard the top four. There's a few Linux, there's Windows, there's Azure virtual machines, there's Azure Arc servers, whatever. This will all work with Automanage. Now, let's skip down to the configuration, which is the next step. You'll see I've got two environments here. There's a dev test and there's a production environment. So when I compare them, that's when I see what's available in each environment and which services actually get enabled for me. So I've got Machine Insights Monitoring, Backup, Azure Security Center, anti-malware, update management, change tracking, guest configuration with the baseline. So the one interesting piece about the guest configuration baseline is that it's applied a little bit differently for both Linux and Windows. In Linux, we apply the baseline in just an audit-only mode. So within your guest assignments, you'll get to see each individual line item in your baseline and how your virtual machine or your Arc server might differ from the recommendation in the baseline, but we won't actually change anything in your server. From a Windows perspective, we actually will go in and we'll do an audit plus remediate. So we'll actually go in and correct things that are not conformant with the baseline. So that's an interesting piece to note there. Automation account, log analytics workspace, like I mentioned, supporting services for some of these above, and then boot diagnostics for Azure virtual machines. That's what we enable for the production profile. Now, if we switch to the dev tests, you'll notice that monitoring and backup disappear. That's because they both charge a little bit extra in terms of service within their service, so we don't want to include them by default. And I mean, in a dev test environment, you probably don't care too much about backing it up or monitoring it. So that's that. I'll leave it as production for now. You'll notice a configuration preference as well. So I can also create a new preference, which will allow me to do a couple extra detailed things. Now I'm going to show these to you. Do note that they're only available for Azure virtual machines and they're not yet supported for Azure Arc. So there's backup. You can tweak some of the backup frequency or how long I retain it for. And then for anti-malware, there's a bunch of settings as well that I can tweak, or I can just disable it altogether. Now, since I'm onboarding some Arc machines, I'm just going to stick with the best practices. And then I'll talk about advanced here as well. So the advanced, pretty simple. It's just an Automanage account, just an identity under which Automanage will operate to do things in your subscription. Now, there we go. That's the onboarding process. So I hit enable, we'll wait a little bit. I mean, it takes about 10 minutes to get everything onboarded. So we won't sit around here. I won't subject you to sitting around with me for 10 minutes while these things onboard. But now they're in progress and they'll be onboarded. So let's pop back over to the deck. So in terms of supported operating systems, this is what we've got so far. So obviously we've got Windows Server support, 2012 R2 and above. We've got CentOS, RHEL, Ubuntu, and SLES support as well. So you can see the different versions here. Take a screenshot or something, or these are all noted in our docs if you want to cross-reference against what you currently have. Now, here's some extra details about kind of our current state and current supported features and whatnot. Like, as I mentioned earlier, we are in public preview. We support both Windows and Linux on Azure and Arc. So both different types of OSs and both different platforms, you can use Automanage on all this stuff. And in terms of pricing, this is another question that we get a lot. We're free. We don't charge anything to use Azure Automanage. And we intend for this best practice service to be free for the duration of its life. But do note that some of the services we enroll in will incur some usage fees. So again, like backup, for example, will charge a little bit for the backup vault for the storage incurred there. Monitoring will charge a little bit for the metrics and to store those metrics and just the data storage there. So there's a little bit of a fee there. Now, from an Automanage and Arc perspective, our supported features, of course, the hybrid instance metadata service, what would we do without it? There's guest config and baselines, there's Azure Monitor, there's Azure Update Management, Azure Policy, and change tracking and inventory. So with that, I'll wrap things up. Thanks for listening to this on-demand session. You can check out the links here to try out both Arc and learn more about Automanage. And then if you ever have any other questions or anything, feel free to just reach out to this email, automanageexperts@microsoft.com. I'm one of the people in the email, but there are a ton of other people, well, a handful of other people behind there that are also super, super helpful and very knowledgeable about Automanage from the product team and whatnot. So I'll thank you for your time, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the hybrid event.